on gate two. Darren Trelaw, gate three. Steve Hollybone, gate four. Perfect starting. Gary Trelaw, in fact, gets it. Alan Ardis with him. And Darren Trelaw hasn't made the best of starts. And Ardis gets round that Coventry corner and leads at the back straight for the first time. Darren Trelaw moves through to second. They're both unbeaten as they meet in heat number 11. Darren Trelaw goes to line around the outside. Ardis looking for him up the inside, but he still holds Trelaw at bay. As Ardis sent from Darren Trelaw. Gary Trelaw in third. Hollybone finds a pace to hop this one. Ardis almost locked it up, coming up the Coventry corner. And Trelaw almost got inside him. So Ardis holds him at bay, 10 yards now. Trelaw driving from inside again, but Ardis just too quick. About one sidecar length between them as they make their way into that Coventry corner once again. Ardis from down Trelaw. Gary Trelaw in third. Ardis has locked up, he's left the gap, and Trelaw's got inside. You can't give that man an inch. He just left a little gap, and Darren Trelaw went storming through it. Ardis in second, Gary Trelaw in third. Hollybone at the back, so it looks like Alan Ardis is going to lose his unbeaten tag here, but a superb ride by Darren Trelaw. And Alan Ardis' bike, he's got his left hand in the air. He's nursing a sick bike. Can he get it home for a second spot? It would be totally unjust to be lost. He's going to get it home, I think. He's just got it home. His hand went in the air halfway up the back straight. How crucial that was in him being beat, we will never know. But in fairness to Darren Trelaw, he really is absolute dynamite on that sidecar. He harassed and harassed at Ardis. Finally, Ardis under pressure, moved out, left a little gap. Trelaw went storming through it. Ardis clung on grimly with a sick bite to a magnificent second spot. Gary Trelaw picks up another third. Four to the Ozzies.
Really exciting. And the England riders are proving to be our equal in plenty of departments, including the gating. And I think during this five test series, Australia will really have to lift our game if we're going to take this 5-0 as we dream of.
I don't know about taking a 5-0. You've got other test matches coming up, at Reading being the next one on Monday. So obviously some of your Aussie boys, have you had a chance to have a look at the speedway circuits?
No, Peter, the team arrived on Thursday of last week, this week, 2 days ago. And last night they had a media reception at Arena Essex, and we had a tryout there against some of the English boys, which was rather disastrous because two bikes were ridden off in a terrifying crash. However, they were in the workshops today, and Gary Trelaw's bike and Alan Ardis's bike are back on the track, as you can see. And everybody's regrouped, and we're well pleased with the way things are going tonight. There we go. That's not bad work in 2 days, and the riders, of course, have not seen any of the English tracks before. It's totally foreign to them, so they don't know what's ahead at Reading. They don't know what's ahead at King's Lynn, or Cradley Heath, or Swindon. Obviously, the British boys do. They do have the home track advantage, but we would like to think that we can win this series 5-0, but on tonight's performance, I won't say too much more. I'm just really pleased that the English boys are so competitive.
All right, more from Peter White later on. Peter Warshap in the box, the official race results.
And the result of Heat 11, winning outfit in white, Darren Trelaw and Alan Griffiths, still unbeaten, 70.6 the winning time, 70.6. Second in red was Alan Ardis and Dave Taylor. And third in yellow and black, Gary Trelaw and Steve Summerling. 2 points to England, four to Australia. 11 heats gone, it's England 30, Australia 36. Change in heat 12. In blue, it's Rob Henderson and Mick Jones. Rob Henderson and Mick Jones ride in blue for heat 12. And I think they're on 2 minutes. 2 minutes for the outfits for heat 12.
Heat 12, Paul Pinford in red, a change in blue. Rob Henderson rides in blue in place of Len Foreman. Wonder why Brian Ash hasn't been given the next ride. He's sitting in the action all night and got 4 points from three rides. Gary Moon rides in white and Shane Sutar in yellow and black. I think Rob Henderson might find the pace a little bit too hot for him in this one. A little bit surprised Brian Ash hasn't been given a ride. We don't know whether Alan Ardis was out on Paul Pinfold's machine that last race because it finished with a sick bike. So if he was, let's hope they've got it quickly repaired. It's going to get that bike very much of a thrashing, I'm afraid. And these two are the kingpins for England, and so much depending on them tonight.
Paul Pinfold's going to have gate one. Shane Sutar, gate two. Rob Anderson, gate three. And Gary Moon, gate number four. I think the onus very much on Pinfold. I think they'll. Rob Anderson might find Moon and Sutar a little bit too much for him. Settling at the tapes. Away in Pinfold, twice the top. Anderson's going in third with Moon at the back. But Anderson's too wide in that cob, and they've got a Moon already. Oh, moves from the third. And Sutar trying to get inside Pinfold. Pinfold left the gap. Coming up the Coventry corner, but Sutar still back in second. They come off that pitch corner and three complete one. And it's Pinfold who shows in from Sutar. Moon in third. Anderson not too far behind the Aussie boys. They make their way into that Coventry corner once again. Pinfold's got it set up at the front, looks behind him, and he's got 30 or 40 yards. I think Sutar may have a sick bike back there in third spot. Can Anderson close the gap and pinch a third? As Pinfold well away at the front, it's still Moon in second. Sutar in third. And as Moon's bike has gone, I think Moon's bike may have gone, and it ends in through into third spot. As Pinfold well away at the front, it's Sutar in second. Anderson not too far behind Sutar. They make their way into the Coventry corner once again. So another one coming up here for Paul Pinfold. Anderson having a go for Sutar. Second spot is Moon cruising with that sip bike at the back. As Paul Pinfold wins it, second is going to be Shane Sutar, and third spot it's Rob Anderson.
So your race winner then, once again, Paul Pinfold.
And the official results of heat 12, the winner in red, Paul Pinfold and Peter Foster. And the winning time for that heat was 71.2. Second in yellow and black was Shane Souter and Dave Martin. And third in blue, Rob Henderson and Mick Jones. Four to England, two to Australia, and with just three heats to go in this first 1,000cc sidecar speedway test match, it's England 34, Australia 38. 4 points in it, going into heat 13. One alteration, of course, with the passenger in yellow, it's Wayne Thompson. Wayne Thompson's the passenger, the outfit in yellow.
The invisible man, I'm the invisible man. Incredible how you came. Right through me.
It's Rob Henderson and Mick Jones. Rob Henderson and Mick Jones in red for heat 13.
Terrible news for England. Alan Arthur's unable to come out in race 13. It's Rob Henderson, the reserve, has got to ride in red. And that really is a bitter blow because himself and Pinfold have really carried the fight to the Aussies. And to lose your equal top rider is a desperate blow indeed. Just for the difference. Anyway, it's Brian Ash. He's been the contention all evening. He's there, gate one. Darren Terrell on beaten, gate two. Rob Anderson, gate three. Shane Horton, gate number four.
Don't worry. Here we go then.
Being held, and Trelaw makes a good get. Asket, Anderson, the act is well. Asket's a corner first. Trelaw trying to come through, and Horton goes straight in the back of Ash and turns the somersault. And Ash won't let Trelaw through, but Trelaw's got round the outside. And Ash trying to come back at Trelaw, the inside that pit's coming, almost touched there. As Darren Trelaw shows them for Ash, it's Anderson third, and we've got a bike trapped. The outfit of Horton is trapped on the track, so the race is stopped.
Machine right in the middle of the track. Can be a little dangerous at times, as you'll appreciate. We'll look for it again.
Well, obviously stopped in the interest of safety. The outfit in yellow and black is excluded. The outfit in yellow and black. So three starters only for the rerun of heat 13.
So at the tapes, and Ash makes a good game. He's made it better again the last time. He leads the control. Trying to go for the outside, cuts back for into Ash, closing him down. As Ash shows in from Trelaw, these two pulling away from Anderson. How long can Brian Ash keep the unbeaten Darren Trelaw in second spot? That's the question. Moving off the pits corner and through to complete one.
Trelaw trying to look for a gap on the inside. Ash won't move over, and Ash still holds Trelaw at bay. He's forced Trelaw, Ash into an area, he's left the gap. What a super ride again by Darren Trelaw. He just simply pressurised Brian Ash so hard, he had to move over. And it's Trelaw who shows in from Ash. Henderson in third, and they make their way into the Coventry corner once again. So it looks if Darren Trelaw is going to go through the programme rides unbeaten. He's pulling away from Ash. Now Anderson, a long way back in third, but it's going to keep it a three-all situation. Still just four difference. As Trelaw then from Ash. Anderson, a long way back in third. They make their way down the back straight for the final time. So a super programme maximum for Darren Trelaw, and has come from the back on each occasion in absolutely scintillating style. Darren Trelaw wins it. Second, and a good second there, Brian Ash. The third spot, Rob Henderson, three apiece again, and still just four the difference.
Just when we could have stole the thunder from Peter White, but we didn't quite, so 3 points each. And England's still got a bit of fighting to do. And another two heats coming up, heat 14, obviously, and the nominated riders race, heat 15, as in traditional speedway. I will talk to Peter White about who he's going to nominate in a moment or two. We'll check that out. But in the meantime, over to Peter Morris with the official race results of heat 13.
Of course, they finish only their course in heat 13. The winning outfit in white, Darren Trelaw and Alan Griffiths. And their winning time was 70.3. Second in blue, it was Brian Ash and Steve Robbins. And third in red, Rob Henderson and Mick Jones. Points divided, three each, two heats to go. It's England 37, Australia 41. 37 points to 41. On there to heat 14. Of course, it's the Steve Ivo, Keith Wall partnership riding in blue.
Frantic work on Rob Henderson's bike in the pits because these machines do get very, very hot indeed. Of course, on the grass, they're used to much bigger circuits than this. The heavy engine's racing furiously on this show tonight, and men and machine really taking quite a pounding. And as I say, some of the English boys, not exactly in the first flush of use, and taking 3 in the trot really does take it out of you.
Speedway stock car meeting at Brandon this season on sale from the track shop, and the tapes include interviews, live commentary and 2 camera mix of the racing, and videos of the recent Midland Championship grass track meeting at Southam, which includes 500,000cc sidecar action, are also on sale. So if you want some videos, the track shop's the place to go. Of course, the track shop situated in Speed Square. Well, here we go now for heat 14, just 4 points in it in this first ever 1,000cc sidecar Speedway International. And it's one alteration, of course. In blue, it's Steve Alibone and Keith Wall. 37 points to 41, it's all on heat 14. 1 minute remaining, 1 minute. Just 30 seconds remaining, 30 seconds.
But one thing is for sure, this has set this series up for a great tussle. I think the Aussie boys have been surprised how well the England lads have handled this tonight, because they are out-and-out professionals in Australia, and these English lads are part-time grass trackers, let's not forget that. And they really have made a brave fist of it. Anyway, at the tapes for 14, Phil McKay, gate 1. Steve Halliburton, gate 2. Brian Coppy, gate 3. Rob Henderson, gate 4. Can the England boys get some of this and take it into a last heat decider? At the tapes of 14. Away, and it's Halliburton making a good gate, but Henderson's last away by the Aussie boys. One goes inside Halliburton, one goes out, so that could be disastrous. But this Coppy leads at the back straight, being chased by McKay. Halliburton in third, Henderson, I think, probably absolutely exhausted. He's way at the back already. And what a shame that is. It's not going to be a last heat decider. As Coppy leads in from McKay, Halliburton in third, these three, a long way of Henderson, in fact, who has packed up. He's not going to throw himself or his machine after doing 3 on the trot. So it looks like the Aussies are going to seal a victory with a 5-1 in race 14. As Coppy around the outside, McKay up his inside, Halliburton trying to come back at them, but still on the receiving end of a 5-1 at the moment, as they make their way down the back straight. Once again, Coppy along with third teammate McKay. Halliburton in third can make an impression as they make their way off the pits corner and through on to lap number four in heat 14 of this first sidecar international. Coppy hugs the line, McKay follows him round, taking exactly the same line that Coppy's taking. Halliburton losing contact all the time, so a 5-1 here for the Aussies in 14. Well settled up for Australia in this first Test match series. Brian Coppy wins it. Second, Phil McKay. Third spot, Steve Halliburton. That sews it up for the Aussies. But we do now await a cracking nominated riders race, particularly if Alan Artis can ride.
Well, we've got to give it to the Aussies. They're really giving everybody a run for their money. Give credit where it's due. We'll go over to Peter Morris, and then Peter will hand back to me. We'll look at the riders for the nominated riders race, Heat 15, in a moment.
The reserves, and that virtually settles it. There's still, of course, the nominated heat to come. The result of heat 14, the winners in yellow and black were Bernie Coffey and Bill Harry. Their time 73.3. Second in white, Phil McKay and Ken Jones. And third in blue, it was Steve Halliburton and Keith Wall. 1 point to England, 5 to Australia. And with just one heat to go, it's England 38, Australia 46. 73.3 the winning time. On now to heat 15, and the outfits are as follows. In red, it's Paul Pinfold and Peter Foster. In blue, it's Brian Ash and Steve Robbins. Riding in white, unbeaten so far, Darren Treloar and Alan Griffiths. And in yellow and black, it's Steve Horton and Wayne Thompson. That's your lineup for Heat 15. Well, we'll wait for the outfits for Heat 15. A result from Kings Lynn, no doubt it'll interest a few people. It was Kings Lynn 44, Coventry 46. So congratulations to the Bees, and we hope to have the individual scores for you in a few minutes. But it was Kings Lynn 44, Coventry 46.
England have got 1-3 in this nominated riders race. That might make it interesting indeed. Brian Ash is going to have gate one. Darren Treloar, unbeaten from four, gate two. Paul Pinfold, 14 from five, gate three. And Steve Horton in gate four, he's got seven. And an exclusion from four. Final heat before we have the individual efforts. Green lights on, a perfect start, and Treloar's made a good gate. He's going to get the corner first. Can Pinfold do him in the back? He can't, he's on the outside of Ash at the moment, and Ash somewhat takes along the Pinfold once, and Horton gets her inside Ash, and that Ash had dropped back from second to last. As Treloar shows end from Pinfold, it's Horton in third. Aussie 1-3 at the moment, as Treloar leads into that pits corner. Coventry corner for the second time, it's Pinfold in second, Horton in third, Brian Ash at the back. And what Darren Treloar, I think the first time that he's made the gate all evening, he's had to do the hard way for the back. He made the gate, the nominated, and Pinfold under pressure for the second spot now as they move into that Coventry corner once again. Treloar this time to look over his shoulder. Sis Pinfold 20, 30 yards behind him. Horton third, Ash having to go to Horton for that third spot again as they make their way off the pits corner and through on to lap four. Treloar from Pinfold, Horton in third, Ash at the back. And that's the order up the back straight then for the final time. Looks to the end as we began with a 4-2. But all credit to the English boys for taking the Aussies up until heat 14 before they finally succumbed. As Darren Treloar, a brilliant 15-point maximum. Second, Paul Pinfold. Third spot, Shane Horton. Super action from Darren Treloar. It's my first view of this young man. And my word, he's a super sidecar rider. He made the gate for the first time tonight. Pinfold the first to shake his hand. All credit to Paul Pinfold for getting this England side together. And all credit to the England side for putting up a superb performance against this very strong Aussie side.
First sensational speedway test match, the 1000cc sidecars. Good entertainment indeed. The winner and a great maximum in white, Darren Treloar. Darren Treloar, of course, partnered by Alan Griffiths. A fine win there. His time, 70 seconds. 70 seconds. Second in red was Paul Pimfold and Peter Foster. And third in yellow and black, Steve Horton and Wayne Thompson. 2 points to England, 4 to Australia. And the final result of this historic first international match, England 40, Australia 50. Well, Australia have obviously got the experience at this sport. They did come as the masters. But congratulations to both teams. 10 points in the end. England 40, Australia 50. The time for heat 15, 70 seconds.
Australian boys on their way around then, and victory for them in this, the first test match in the United Kingdom. Peter White is by my side. Peter, you must be very pleased with the boys.
Very proud, Pete, very proud. All the boys have done us proud tonight. The first time ever, this is a historic occasion, the first time anywhere in the world that two teams have met in international combat on speedway sidecars, and the Aussies following in the footsteps of the cricketers. Done us proud, but I must say that the English riders made a good fight of it, and I hope that the people here tonight will appreciate that they saw some splendid speedway, and let's hope that it's the springboard for further success for speedway sidecar action in England.
Well, I'm glad you didn't dwell too heavily on... Oh, nice, thank you very much. That's just what we needed from Colin Meredith. Certainly deserve it tonight. The Australians who've come over to the UK, a little bit jet lagged, shall we say, but certainly got the bit between their teeth and pulled up a win in this, the first test match.
I'm really surprised by the scoreline. I have to be honest, I really thought that Australia would walk away by 20 or more points. The fact that England hung in so close is something to be proud of. I am a little worried about the rest of the series. I thought we'd cakewalk it. After tonight, I know we won't. In Pinfold and Artis, you've got two of the best. If they can get backing from Brian Ash and a few of the other boys, we are in some difficulty.
I've now got with me Darren Treloar and his passenger. Is that the right way to pronounce your name?
Yep. Treloar, yeah.
And his passenger. Congratulations. Super 15-point maximum, but you must have been surprised how close the Englishmen pushed you tonight.
Yeah, there's no doubt about the Englishmen. They pretty fast. I struggled a bit there, and I just won me five races. The track was really good, and I enjoyed it.
How different was it riding here at Coventry to the big Australian tracks? It's one of the biggest speedway tracks we have got, but you must have found it rather small after the big Aussie circuits.
Yeah, well, that's like one of our smallest tracks in Australia, but the track's beautiful, and I like it. It's really good to ride.
It's amazing you should say that, because when the Speedway boys come in, they always say it's one of the best prepared tracks in the country.
Yeah, well, it's a bit different between us and the solos. We like it a bit heavier, and it's not quite as heavy as at home. They're more drivier. There's more dirt on them.
We'll have a word with your passenger now. You're getting very close to the ground once or twice. Superb meeting, and you must be really pleased to win the first of this series.
Yeah, love it. Couldn't have come at a better time for us. Paul's very fast, same with Alan. He's bringing the Englishmen along very well. They're going to be very hard over the next four test matches. It'll be great racing.
It's a rather unique situation, the opening pairing with you and your dad. There can't be many sports where we've got a father and son opening combination.
Yeah, it's a bit different, but it's just like racing anyway. I just treat it the same, and so does he. We just have fun.
You're going to Reading on Monday, which is about 40, 50 yards smaller than this and not so wide, so obviously you're going to find that a little bit different again.
Yeah. Well, we ran on track on
Arena Essex.
Yeah,
safety fence.
Yeah. Well, that was rather small and tight, so we'll just have to learn to adapt to it.
I've now got with me the England skipper, Paul Pinfold. Paul, I spoke to you before the meeting. We had to speak to you again. You must be highly delighted the way the English boys have given it everything tonight.
They've all gone their best. We've had a bit of machine trouble, which has lost us quite a few points, but the boys have gone really good tonight against these. These are top blokes against us, so we've got to be proud of them.
A great pity you lost Solon Artis in his last programme ride, and one would have thought he'd have rode the nominated, and that could have made it really tight, the result at the end.
That's right. I think that made all the difference to the score. Alan's a real, real hard goer, and he gets the score, so it was a shame we lost him.
Great credit to all the English boys, because as you say, the Aussies are out and out professionals, and it can only do the series of pair of good. You've lost by 10, you were unlucky to lose by 10. People who see how competitive it is, and that should boost the attendance into the rest of the series.
That's right. I think when the English boys know they see what they're up against, they'll all be working on their machinery and everything, and we'll be up to scratch against them next time.
And Reading on Monday, a little bit smaller, could favour the English boys a little bit more, do you think?
Maybe. They haven't got many tracks like that in Australia, so we're hoping it will work on our side, as long as we can get all their machinery up to scratch.
Talking of their team, their young lad, Darren Trelaw, absolute revelation. The only rider to beat you, and he came through from the back three or four times. Absolutely superb riding.
That's right. Young Darren used to spanner for me when he was 14 years old in Australia, and I used to let him ride my bike, and I knew when he had a go on it, he was going to be an instant star, and he's showing his head, so we've just got to keep a lookout for him in the future.
As a man who's put in so much effort to get this series off the ground, you really must be delighted with the result of tonight's match and the effort put in by both sides.
Yeah, I am really. There's so much work gone into it. Until I got here tonight, I'm relieved now. It's all happening. So I think it can only go from strength to strength now.
Thanks very much, Paul. Congratulations to you and the England side, who took it virtually to a last seat decider.
Right, thank you.
CC sidecar individual feature finale, and the outfits are as follows. In red, number one, in red outfit is Paul Pinfold and Peter Foster, and the blue outfit is Albert Lewis and Brian Higgin. The white outfit is Darren Trelaw and Alan Griffiths, and the yellow black outfit Gary Trelaw and Steve Summerling.
Albert Lewis in blue, Darren Trelaw in white, Gary Trelaw yellow and black, Paul Pinfold on gate one. It's Gary Trelaw gate two, Albert Lewis gate three, Darren Trelaw gate four. They're all edging into the tapes, and Pinfold makes a tremendous gate for the inside. Gary Trelaw's got out with him, Lewis in third, and Darren Trelaw's right at the back. Only one nasty one there as Gary Trelaw locked up on the inside. His son is quickly back to see if his father's okay. Locked up on the inside, the two outfits around the outside. We're trying to go around there, and
Gary Trelaw down on the track. His son quickly back to his father's okay. Let's hope that they're both fit, but they are excluded from the rerun of heat one.
For the first time tonight, Darren Trelaw was way at the back. He totally missed the gate. Pinfold was away. Lewis was away as well. Gary Trelaw was away. Locked up on the inside. That forced Albert Lewis to take evasive action, and Darren Trelaw was on the outside, just simply had nowhere to go. What a sad way to end this meeting. There's a stretcher ride
I'm not sure whether it's for the father or for his passenger, but what a tragedy after a super 15 heats of entertainment, the first heat at the interval, and we have a stretcher ride for one of the Aussie boys. Dart. Bearing in mind when we used to have the 6 outfit handicap, when we had the sidecar sporadically through last season, it could make for very interesting racing indeed.
1 minute remaining, 1 minute for the 3 outfits for heat one, 1 minute.
And it's going to be Paul Pinfall, gate one, no Riley, gate two, Albert Lewis, gate three, Darren Trelaw on gate number four. Restart, heat one of the second half. Engines begin to pick up the revs away, and Pinfall again makes a super gate, looks across and sees that Trelaw has got out with him, and Pinfall goes for an outside line, thinking Trelaw was coming around the outside, but Trelaw cut back for an inside line, but the wet track found his wheel spinning, and still Pinfall knows too much at the moment, and Pinfall in fact was 10, 15 yards clear coming through, two complete, one lap then. Pinfall from Trelaw, Lewis was a somewhat sick bike, a long way back in third, and Trelaw's going to work hard to get the Pinfall now. Might he be facing defeat for the first time tonight? Pinfall then from Trelaw. Pinfall goes wide, Trelaw, big burst of speed round the outside, took some grain off Pinfall there, but still Pinfall has the advantage as they make their way into the Coventry corner once again, down about 5 yards between them. Pinfall's gone wide, Trelaw and Turner went for line round the outside, lost out there, still about 10 yards of difference. They make their way into that pits corner once again, Pinfall with the outside, and Trelaw's falling round the outside. There wasn't too much between them there as they came off that pits corner onto lap four now. Pinfall goes for the outside again, Trelaw's not trying that drive on the inside, going for power round the outside, but Pinfall still holds him at bay. It's no one over Trelaw. He gives it everything round the outside. Pinfall goes wide to block him. Trelaw comes to lay up the inside, and Pinfall gets it. Super action there. Pinfall knew everything that Trelaw was going to do. He kept going for the outside. Pinfall shut the door in his face on every occasion. His desperate dive for the inside of the running for line was thwarted by Pinfall again. So Trelaw beaten for the first time tonight. I imagine he'll get through as fast as second. He wasn't that far behind Pinfall. And let's hope they meet in a handicap final.
Well, give us applause, some fine racing there in heat one, some very good racing indeed. The winner, but only just, in red, Paul Pinfold and Peter Foster. Winning time was 75.2. Second, in white, it was Darren Trelaw and Alan Griffiths. And third, in blue, Albert Lewis and Brian Higgins. 75.2, the winning time. And the outfits for heat two in red, it's Steve Allibone and Keith Wall. Steve Allibone and Keith Wall. In blue, it's Len Foreman and Ray Foreman. Len Foreman and Ray Foreman. In white, it's Gary Moon and Craig Hall. Gary Moon and Craig Hall. And in yellow and black, it's Steve Horton and Wayne Thompson.
So as they make their way into line four, heat two, then it's going to be Steve Horton on gate one. Steve Allibone, gate two. Gary Moon, gate three. And Len Foreman with gate number four. They move into their prospective gating positions. Away, and it's Horton who makes a good gate. Moon gets out with him. Foreman in third, and that's short around that Coventry corner. Moon trying to come round Horton. Horton leads the gap, and Moon sweetly around the outside to move in the first spot. And here comes Foreman in the action.